All right, and you can also name him what you want. But I just decided to name him Donna Chad because I don't care about him. So, as soon as you have kids, assign a guardian. And he's a second son, which means I want him to be a soldier so I can kill him off or do whatever. He's less important, essentially. Your first son, depending on where you are, you want to teach him in either stewardship or diplomacy. Stewardship early on so you can get the extra coins and get that money going. Once you're a king or an emperor, which takes about 4 or 5 generations when you're starting out, you can probably get there earlier once you get better at the game, but then after you have a lot of vassals, you want diplomacy education so that your vassals like you and you can have more of them. But, when you're less than a king and you're like, oh man, I've got 13 out of 20 versus 13 out of 30, like you're still not at your max, so your max doesn't matter. But once you become a king and an emperor, it's a little more important. So we're gonna play this and we're gonna speed it up a little bit. Starting as a small nation, it's a lot of waiting. I mean, you can micromanage and marry people off and try and do stuff like that, but it's less important. Aha. So, let's see. This guy, he is not being educated. So occasionally you want to go through and make sure that everything's going right with your dynasty. He's a firstborn, just in case. Stewardship. And then same with this guy. Although he's an adult, I don't know what I was trying to do. But the traits for our family's not good, and they're all the second education level for Marshall, and I'm not sure why. That was weird. Because I think it's random, so it's very interesting that many of them got that education, but that's okay. Some of the mods I would recommend is
Okay.
Old Gods. So I will actually bump it up to 4 because nothing too interesting is happening. This is why mods are fun. So some of the mods I would recommend is Old Gods. Basically, oh wow. Who did I marry you to? Oh yeah, the guy was like, "Hey, marry me off," and I married him to Norway. Oh, well, your wife just died. So new wife time. You're 39. You don't need more kids. Let's do someone fairly old. That seems good. Just got high education, so you can teach people. That's good. But yeah, we'll resume. And some. Ooh, my castle walls are done building. And you accepted the marriage. Fantastic. So, if I go to my military, I went up a little bit. I think it was at 5 or 859, and now I'm at 866, so I added like 7 troops or something. But I'm gonna switch from fabricating that claim to improving this guy's relationship with me, because if I can do that, I get more of his and more of his troops. Wow, that was really quick, almost immediately. But as you can see here, it calculates how many of his troops I'm able to raise. And it's based on his opinion and then the laws. So because he likes me, I can get more of his men. But wife's pregnant again. So I'm gonna take this back down a little bit. Stuff's happening and I'm trying to talk about mods. So Old Gods, super important, allows you to play this whole area, Scandinavia, Baltic area, I think even Denmark. I don't know. Some people consider that Scandinavia, some don't. But you can play all this area as the pagan Norse in the Viking Age, clearly. And you can raid, and it unlocks a new government type and earlier start date. It's, to me, my favorite mod or DLC, and it's the most important DLC. So, second would probably be Charlemagne, because, again, it's a fun start. Unlocks not too much, so maybe not your second one, but it's another one that's up there to consider buying. Way of Life and Conclave are both important. And then the Death's Due, I would say, is another important one. I actually don't have that one, but it is on my buy list for sure, because it unlocks disease mechanics and plagues and a whole bunch of fun stuff. Instead of just getting injured, you can like lose hands instead of just like a generic debuff. And so it adds a lot more individuality and character to the game. And at the current game time, they have the epidemic thing without the mod, and like occasionally you'll get camp fever or something stupid, but I've never seen anything important happen in that. So, you know, you get a disease for a week and maybe it kills a distant relative, but I've never had anything important happen. But it'd be interesting. So, here we go. Bumped up that dude's relation with me, and now I can have more of his vassals, troops. So, if I go look at this guy, he's at 800. That's his max. If I click on me, I'm up to 1.9. So, theoretically, I could fight him. It's probably best to either forge an alliance with somebody. Like, if I go over to Wales, my father-in-law, he will now accept. That's awesome. And so now I can go to war. There it goes. We'll take this down. Right click on him, declare war, because we have de jure claim of his county because we own the duchy title. And I will raise my men, call my ally, and raise my vassals. I don't think that called him in. Sometimes that button works, sometimes it doesn't. But let's try this. Actually, he's going to march right on me. Interesting. Good luck with that, sir. So, make sure you have commanders in your armies. And here we go. Oh, good. I had another son. This is not happening. Why am I only having sons? I want daughters. I want to marry daughters off. So, until you can change your succession law, and you have, I think most people start with Gavelkind. So, Gavelkind splits your titles among your three sons. So, if I were to get another county, as soon as this character dies and I become my son, I lose counties to my now brother, and that sucks. Because you fought so hard to make this, and now it's a different person, and because I don't have claim to that duchy, I might even lose it. Oh, cool. So, I just gained Wrath, or Roth, which adds 3 martial, but I lose intrigue and diplomacy. Intrigue and diplomacy are not really my strong points. Marshall is, so now I can get even more troops. So, I'm okay with this. And my Marshall... Oh, wow. So usually, you'll win this battle, Wales will come over, help you siege this down, and you can win. Your war score gets high enough that, with the one battle and sieging two of the holdings, I think... I mean, your numbers might be slightly different, but you just barely can win without having to wait for the bishopric to go down, or the town to go down. But since I captured him in battle, I can immediately sue him for peace. So, I now own that duchy. Or that county, I have the complete duchy. So, from here on out, I need to fabricate claims to expand. So, we'll fabricate on Sildara. Looks like Normandy ended up winning, and he's still at war with Norway. But it's in favor of William the Conqueror, so he's not going to lose it. That's good. Mega Norway is scary. And since that lady died, I'm no longer allied with them. But when you play Ireland, your first goal will be to secure this duchy. Your second one is probably start fabricating claims here and here. I usually get these seven. And then you have a majority of the titles for the Kingdom of Ireland. It's only 13 counties, so you have 7 of the 13. And you can create the title, and then you get de jure claim for the rest, just how I took this one. So you don't have to worry about a cause for war. But like, I can't just randomly attack this guy. It won't let me. I don't have a valid reason to attack him. So I have to wait for my steward or my chancellor to fabricate claims. Also, this guy isn't doing anything, so I'm sending him to the Pope, because I don't feel like getting excommunicated. But, so, yeah, shoot for the Kingdom of Ireland. If Scotland's weak, which most of the time it is, you can swoop in, get that. Hopefully your succession law isn't Gavelkind at that point, because if you have Gavelkind succession still, you'll lose the Kingdom of Scotland, you'll become Ireland, or vice versa, depending what your primary one is, and then you'll have to fight your dynasty member, your brother or whatever, and that's a pain in the butt. So try and change succession law before you move past the Kingdom of Ireland, which is difficult to do, but all it requires is you being in charge for 10 years and all of your vassals to like you. This guy just got his ass whooped in a war, so he's not going to be a fan of me for a while. At least 10 years. Really, I have to wait 25. Or 23? What's that? 12. Jesus, math is hard. Yeah, so I wait 12 years, and then he'll like me, and I can probably change succession laws. Another option is, once you take the Kingdom of Ireland, go for Wales or go for Brittany. Brittany, for the most part, stays independent from France, and you can take it easy for some extra land. The only problem is you need to have enough ships to move your armies back and forth. So these dotted lines here allow armies to move across. There's like ferry crossings or whatever. And so you can get between Ireland and the rest of the British Isles without ships. But England does not connect to the rest of Europe, nor does it connect to like Scandinavia or anything. But this island does connect. But yeah, they've got Iceland tucked up here too. But yeah, if you're on the fence for buying this game, I would recommend it. Wait for it to go on sale. There's a new DLC coming out. It's going to be awesome. It's redoing a whole bunch of stuff. The Crusades are basically getting revamped, which is funny because it's Crusader Kings and they're just now fixing it after like 6 years. But it's going to totally change the Catholic Crusade dynamic. And I think it's changing a couple areas on the map. I had heard rumors that Ireland is during our mission to fabricate my claim. Chancellor has been murdered. Oh, dang. He was a family member, too. That is sad. So, I can get some piety and diplomacy for mourning his death. Yeah, I'm gonna do that because, he was pretty good. So, I'm gonna send this random guy now. Bye. Okay. So, I've got a little bit more money. Time has gone on. Let's see. Nothing worth spending money on. I don't need to upgrade my fortifications. But, yeah. So, the next DLC is coming out. Kind of one of the reasons I wanted to make this is because, you know, with the new DLC, things get cheap, people buy the game, they don't know how to play it, so hopefully this can help some people, and, you know, it's a fun game, so I don't mind doing this. But, ooh, York is trying to win independence. Let's see if they can do it. Wow, Scotland declared war on them, too. Alright, seems very unlikely. But, if England is weak and fractures, makes our life easier because big, scary England is not as big or as scary. And they'll probably be busy fighting other people. And I am very, I love my wife, apparently. Maybe this one will be a daughter. So, having daughters is good, because you can marry them off for alliances, and if you need, you can marry them matrilineally to grow your dynasty. But my dynasty is big enough, I don't have to worry about that. And I've got plenty of sons. Actually, when I had this one, I didn't assign him a guardian. Whoopsies. This guy's got good education. So, looking at his traits, he will pass down these other traits, but none of them are too terrible. Craven's kind of bad for a leader, but it's not the worst. My marshal just got wounded trying to collect taxes. That's not good. Okay, so still no unrest, but anyways, sidetracked. This game's very busy, I'm sorry. Go back. First one is always education, then usually it's genetic stuff, which is the heart, and then either red or, oh cool, the Pope likes me again. Ooh, likes me, period. He didn't like me before. It's good that he likes me now. But yeah, so genetic stuff is first, and then just normal traits. And so, there's only a possibility of 4 levels for each of the 5 educations. There's an education for each trait, or each stat, I guess I should say. Because I think these are stats and then these are traits. But for each stat, there's an education, and then 4 levels of that education, 1 through 4. So this guy's got the highest martial education, which hopefully he can pass down to my son. And look at that, finally have a daughter. And I am going to name her Miracle. And I also took a screenshot for some reason. Don't know why my screenshot button is backspace, but I will have to fix that in the future.